The Defence Minister got up close and personal with an American nuclear submarine today, which is docked at a naval base in Perth. But yesterday's blistering attack by former Labor Prime Minister Paul Keating on the AUKUS deal was still ringing in the government's ears.
It's nicknamed the Ghost of the Coast. The USS Asheville, dockside of Perth's HMAS Stirling. It's nuclear-powered, a Los Angeles class, not the Virginia class we are getting in 10 years. But Defence Minister Richard Marles, very keen to check out the sort of technology we're getting for $360 billion.
Three subs by the end of the 2030s. Virginia class, is that enough?
We're confident that we are going to be able to evolve our capability from where we are now.
The Vice Admiral in charge of our nuclear sub-program is confident Australia will be packing the punch it needs to fend off any threats.
We will have those Virginias, we'll also have our Collins will be operating, and our Collins will have undertaken their full life of type extension. And I would say that that is a very formidable and lethal force for Australia in the 2030s.
And today the fallout after former Prime Minister Paul Keating savaged the deal, personally attacking Foreign Minister Penny Wong and Defence Minister Richard Marles, calling them unwise.
Our focus is on explaining the benefits of this to the Western Australian people today and explaining the importance of this to the Australian people in terms of our national security.
The most personal attack was saved, though, for Penny Wong.
Running around the Pacific Islands with a lei around your neck handing out money, which is what Penny does, is not foreign policy.
The Foreign Minister taking a diplomatic tone in response.
Paul Keating has his views, but in substance and in tone, they belong to another time.
It was left to the boss to defend his team.
I think it is unfortunate that Mr. Keating chose such very strong personal statements against people. I don't think that does anything other than diminish him, frankly, but that's a decision that he's made.
The AUKUS sub plan is steaming ahead. In the last week, Australian submariners have been training on the USS Asheville. In July, things get serious. Nine News can reveal that's when a Virginia-class submarine will visit HMAS Stirling here at Perth. That's the type of sub we're getting, and it will be the first visit since the AUKUS sub deal was signed.
Mark Burrows, Nine News.